Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and hospitality simple. It's a beautiful spring day. I'm out here and I'm going to show you in this video how to organize a sanitizing station at home. I live in a single family home and so I park on the driveway. I come around here to the front porch area to show you where I've put our sanitation station. Now, I'm filming outside because I need the light. This would be in the garage with the garage door closed. So I wanted to show you this area just so that you could see it better. If you live in an apartment on the first floor, you may want to have this outside your door. You may want to have it inside, right in your foyer area, if you're okay with bringing anything in, including the clothes that you're wearing inside your home. If you live on the second floor, be careful to not drop anything onto your neighbor's porch down below. So this is my front porch area. Before you do anything else, you want to make sure that you have some type of disinfecting wipes, whether bought or homemade, in your car. Make sure to wipe off the steering wheel, the console, any areas that you touch, the dashboard, the inside of the door, the door handles, and then the outside door handles. You can also spray your shoes with a disinfecting wipe. Put it in a bag, leave it in your trunk if you don't want to bring that in. Or what I'm doing is that I can leave my shoes here. So I've taken them off for demonstration. And I just have this black trash bag. I've weighted it down with rocks because it gets windy. And that's where you can lay out your shoes. You can use cardboard. You can even keep it on the concrete if you want. You want to be aware of how long it will stay on surfaces, whether it's a couple hours, 8 hours, 24 hours, or a few days. So think about that when you're setting it up. I know like foil is 2 to 8 hours, cardboard is 24 hours, plastic is a few hours. So that's why I've chosen trash bags, because even after this, you can always take that and just throw it away. It's easier that way. The first thing you want to do is to choose an area. So as I've said, I've chosen this area just to show you, but this would be in the garage. If you have a garage, you can close the door. It will be very private. If you don't have a garage and you need to use the front porch, I think it will be okay. Everyone knows the situation that's going on. Hopefully you can be able to leave it out at night, but if not, then go ahead and put it in your foyer. So after you choose an area, you'll need to, number two, gather your supplies. So these are the supplies that I have. I have a small table, and then I have this little bin to just corral everything and keep it neat. Hand sanitizer, gloves, these are for food preparation, which I think suffice for what we need. I also have the non-latex gloves here. Can you guys hear the birds? They're just like fired up today. Okay, I have hand sanitizer. Now, the reason I have a large hand sanitizer, don't vilify me. My husband has a Pilates studio, so we always have hand sanitizer in stock. So I've had that. And then I have disinfectant spray. You can always make your own. There are lots of videos out there showing you how to make your own. I have Lysol wipes. Again, you can make your own, and they can be store-bought. I have travel size ones here. And then I have over here, doggy bags for trash, a roll of paper towels, and some cleaning rags. Here is a bin with a cover. This is a hook that you put on a table. That is for my purse, but you can have any kind of hook, nails to hang your purse and to hang your clothes. So here I just have these nails because this is what we use actually to put on the Christmas lights every year. So I'm just using it here. So the first step is to choose an area. Second step is to gather your supplies. And then the third step is to determine the order of your sanitizing. All right, so the first thing I would do is to put on some gloves. And like I said, I think these type of gloves, the disposable gloves for food handling, they're recyclable. I think these would be good enough. Now you don't wanna recycle them, you wanna throw them away, right? I just don't want anything contaminated that way. I'm just not sure, okay? So err on the side of caution, go ahead and throw them away. So I think these will protect you enough because you're not going into some really intense situation. You're just trying to disinfect the surfaces that you have on you before going into the house, or once you're in the house to get that all taken care of before you go further into the house or see your family members. So this is what it looks like. It doesn't fit perfectly, but it'll do. Okay, so again, you can always have these type of gloves if you want, if you feel better. I'm just gonna take the disinfectant spray and then go over here to the trash bag where, pretend I'm taking off the shoes, okay? And then I'm just gonna spray the bottom, the sides, the top, and then the other side, and then just try to leave them upside down like that. It's gonna probably go to the side, okay? And then you spray the other one. And remember, you're supposed to let this sit anyway, so this is perfect. And you could just let that sit overnight or for a few hours and grab them later. All right, so I prefer to go ahead and dispose of these gloves because now I'm going to sanitize my purse by wiping it down. Over here, I have little doggy bags and I just want to use these because they're smaller. I don't have to use a whole trash bag or even one of those bags that are for the office trash can. So they're small enough, you don't want to waste it too much. They have these available at the Dollar Tree. Okay, so did you see how I took off the gloves, that I pulled them from here, pulled it that way and then that way and folded it within each other? So you're not touching the outside surface that it touched. Okay, so I'm gonna get more gloves. So this is my purse. I work from home, so I'm not working outside, but I'm just gonna show you what my purse is. I suggest that you get a smaller purse or you just bring your wallet and your phone just so that you have less surfaces to wipe down. So I'll get the handles first, then the sides, okay? And I'm just trying to do this fast. You could do it more thoroughly outside of this video, right? Okay, and then you definitely want to get the bottom. Since these are disinfectant wipes, you want to not use it on leather and you have to test it first. So that's just a disclaimer. This bag is not an expensive bag at all, so it's gonna be okay. And then I have this little hand sanitizer thing from Bath & Body Works. So I just wipe that down. I use this all day long everywhere. Before I grab something, I've been trying to just go to the grocery store once a week, but before you do the touch any button, put in your card, you just have to have a travel size hand sanitizer. Again, you can make your own. You can get a little bottle, a travel bottle that you may have. You can order one. You can find one like at the big box store and just make it. Have that ready at all times. So that's done. So again, I'm just gonna hold this here, take off the gloves from the wrist part, fold it over so you see how that goes inside. Take this other one, fold it into itself or into the other one, and see, now you never touch the outside of the glove. Get the doggy bag again, throw it in there. Okay, so you may be wondering, what do I have the paper towels for or the rags? So example, if I have this disinfectant spray and I don't want to leave my shoes out, I will have to wipe it down with the paper towel. I can use a rag if I want to wash it in hot water afterwards. And then the next step is where I would take a bin. Okay, if you don't have a bin like this with a cover, you can always have a bucket. Like, I think these are very inexpensive at the big box stores. You can also make a cover for it by using cardboard, covering it with aluminum foil. I would cover it with aluminum foil because it stays longer on cardboard surfaces than it does aluminum foil, and that would just be easier to wipe down. Okay, so I have this and it's plastic. Again, easier to wipe down. So I would open this up, okay? And again, assuming I'm in the garage or you're in your foyer, you can take off your clothes and put it in here. Okay, obviously discretion is up to you who is in your household, but this is an answer for those who really don't want to bring anything into the home. Okay, so I would take this, put the clothes in there, including, you know, everything. Cover it up, okay, right? You have the option also to have gloves while you're taking your clothes off. Now, I don't think you have to, because you will have hand sanitizer to do that stuff. You will need like a hook here. I have the nails to hang your clothes. So if you want to put your clothes into the bin and put on something temporarily before you go into the shower, you would have to have a hook, a hanger, and some fresh clothes. I'm just gonna put on gloves just so you see this option. So I would have gloves on again. So remember, the clothes are in here now, okay? The purse has been wiped down, I'm letting it dry. Okay, I have the temporary clothes on me now, so I'm gonna grab this bin. I'm gonna bring this to the laundry room and put the clothes directly into the washer on the highest hot setting that is available. Then I'm gonna take it back, cover it, bring it back out here, and then this is when I can wipe it down, okay? Make sure you wipe down the areas where you have grabbed, especially underneath here, like that. Okay. So, you know, every couple days or so, you can even wash with hot water, warm water, and dishwashing liquid the inside of the bin or the bucket or whatever container you're using. So again, right, soap is really always a good answer for this. Okay, so I've wadded it up again, throwing it in the doggy bag. As I said, you have to determine the order of how you're going to sanitize depending on what area you're in, what you need to sanitize. So those are the basic things. Of course, you can always sanitize your phone. I'm just not going to show that in this video. So after you've thrown this stuff in the washer, you can actually go straight to the shower. Wash up. When you're done with the shower, that's when you can bring out the bin. And now I have the trash here. I'm all fresh and ready. I can grab my purse. I can grab the hanger. I can put fresh new clothes on there. Why do I have a picture of my husband and my kids when they were toddlers? I have it here because it's just a reminder, a visual of why I'm taking all these steps, right? A lot of times we've been feeling, you know, concern, frustration. We want to get out. We're taking a lot more steps than we normally do. Well, we're doing it because of these people right here. So that's just a little suggestion for me that maybe will keep you motivated in doing these things. I hope you enjoyed this video of how to organize a sanitizing station at your home. Please let me know in the comments below what you would add and where you would put your sanitizing station. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought we'd never pay the price.